Assalamu alaikum. Dear students, I hope all of you are fine. Last class, we discussed about heredity in organisms. Today, this is lecture 2. And in this lecture, we are going to discuss about Mendel's experiment, then DNA replication and DNA test. So, Gregor Johann Mendel is known as father of genetics. And all of you know that he did an experiment on pea plant to know about how the characteristics of parents are transmitted to next generation. So in 1866, Gregor Johann Mendel did this experiment on pea plant. And at that time, the unit which is responsible for carrying all the characteristics, that was termed as factor by him, which is now, presently it is now known as gene. Mendel did this experiment to see what are the results of F1 generation and F2 generation. That means F1 generation means first generation, first filial generation, and F2 generation means the second filial generation. So let us know about this experiment done by Mendel. We have to know some terms like what is dominant, what is recessive, what is homozygous and heterozygous. And same type of gene, it has different type of expression. Like if you look at the first one, capital TT, here capital T is responsible for tall characteristics, and this same gene, small t, it's another addition, small t, it is responsible for dwarf characteristics. So Mendel took two pea plants, one is homozygous tall, another is homozygous dwarf. Now the matter is what homozygous is. When the two genes responsible for any characteristics, they are of the same type, then this is known as homozygous for that characteristics. We will not say homozygous pea plant. We have to say homozygous tall plant. When the characteristics containing genes are of same type, that is known as homozygous for that characteristics. So here the two genes are of same type. This is homozygous tall pea plant and this is homozygous dwarf pea plant. So one plant is considered as male plant, another plant is considered as female plant. And here pollen grains from one plant, it is transferred to the stigma of another plant, and precaution is maintained so that other pollen grains from other plants, it cannot be transferred here in this process, so that the result cannot be hampered. Now after this is the phenotype. Genotype means the distribution or arrangement of gene in any organism. So in this pea plant, the genotype is of same, capital T, capital T, and in this dwarf plant it is also same, small t, small t. And phenotype means the expression which we can see from outside, expression of characteristics, expression of genes. So this is tall, this phenotype of this plant is tall, and phenotype of this plant is dwarf. Now all of we know in the gamete, number of chromosomes become half. So here there are two genes in the gamete, there will be two gametes formation from this plant. So this number of chromosome will become half. Half life altogether, when it is fused, it becomes full life. So in case of homozygous dwarf plant, this in this gamete there will be half number of chromosome. And when F1 generation, when crossing is done, when fusion of gametes are done, then all the plants will contain same genotype, capital T, small t, but all plants will be tall, and this is heterozygous tall. It means though there are presence of two genes, But capital T, this tall characteristics containing gene, it will express in the first generation. And so this T, it is dominant in comparison to this small T gene. So this capital T is dominant gene and small T is recessive gene. So dominant recessive gene means dominant gene, it dominates to express the characteristics of recessive gene in the first generation. And recessive gene, it cannot express its characteristics in the first generation, but later on it expresses its characteristics when it is in homozygous condition. Okay, so all the plants we get in first generation, all these are tall plants, but they are heterozygous tall. Heterozygous means when the characteristics containing controlling genes are of different types, then this plant is known as heterozygous for that characteristics, for that tall characteristics. So this is heterozygous tall. Now Mendel wanted to know that in these tall plants, whether there is a small dwarf containing genes that is present or not. So selfing of F1 generation was done, and this is the genotype, heterozygous tall. Then in the gametes, there are two types of gametes produced. One is capital T, another is small t. So when F2 generation is done, then it is seen that we get tall is to dwarf plant in 3:1 ratio. It is not that we are getting only four plants. If we get all the plants, we will get it in 3:1 ratio. Tall plant and dwarf plant in 3:1 ratio, or we can say that 75% plants will be tall and 25% plants will be dwarf. If we want to know genotypic ratio, then this is homozygous tall and these two are heterozygous tall and this is homozygous dwarf. So then the ratio will be 1:2, 2:1. So it means it is seen that this small t, this recessive gene, it is present still in the plant and it will express its characteristics in the next generations. This experiment of Mendel, it is nowadays used for the development of animals for artificial hybridization process. And if we want to get improved characteristics containing plants, so then this experiment of Mendel, it helps nowadays a lot. So in different sectors nowadays, this experiment, this knowledge of experiment, this is used to know how these characteristics are transferred from parents to offspring. Now we have to know about DNA replication. All of we know that in the previous class, we know that Watson and Crick discovered double helix model of DNA. Watson and Crick in 1956 discovered DNA replication process, described DNA replication process. And scientists say that there may be three methods of DNA replication. One is conservative method, another is semi-conservative method, and another is dispersive method. But in your book, there is only a description of semi-conservative method. So we are going to know about semi-conservative method of DNA replication, and which was described by scientists Watson and Crick. What is semi-conservative method? Semi-conservative method of replication means the two daughter DNA that is produced from mother DNA, in this two daughter DNA, both daughter DNA, one strand will be from old or mother DNA and another strand will be newly produced. So this is semi-conservative method. There are three steps in this DNA replication process. First of all, number one, breaking down of hydrogen bonds. All of we know that in between nitrogenous bases, there are hydrogen bonds present. So first step is breaking down of hydrogen bond. Secondly, complementary nitrogenous bases, nucleotides will come and start formation of new DNA strand, complementary DNA strand. And thirdly, formation of two daughter DNA. So these are the steps. Now let us discuss about these steps. So for that, you have to look at the diagram very carefully. Now if we consider that this is the DNA last class we discussed about the structure of DNA. This is double helical structure, double helix model of DNA. So all of we know that one strand, if it goes from 5 to 3 prime, another strand will go from 3 prime to 5 prime. Here, nitrogenous bases, you can write any nitrogenous bases, like you can write AT, then there are two bonds, hydrogen bonds present, then you can write G, C, anyone you can write, C, G, you can write according to your will, but you have to make sure that complementary nitrogenous bases are connected. That means always you remember, always adenine will be connected with thymine, guanine will be connected with cytosine. So this you have to be careful about. Now here, for example, I told about the first step. What is the first step? Breaking down of hydrogen bond. So when hydrogen bonds are broken down, suppose here there was A, so in this strand there will be T, because previously it was twisted condition, but as hydrogen bonds are broken down, so now double strand becomes single stranded. This is single strand. So first step is breaking down of hydrogen bond. So you can draw, you can write any nitrogenous base here. You can write C here, G, any nitrogenous base. If you write down C here, then obviously at this side you have to write down G, because you know that previously they were in twisted condition, double strand condition. So obviously if there is C, cytosine always will be connected with guanine. Like this way, second step, I hope you remember, second step was complementary nitrogenous bases will come. There are free nucleotides present in the cytoplasm. These nucleotides will come and join together. Such as, this is the old DNA, mother DNA, and this is new DNA strand formation. So if there is A, then new DNA strand formation, there will be T, thymine. If C is here, there will be G. So this is the old DNA strand. For example, I'm writing here, suppose I have written here T, then C, then G, then A. So if I write down these nitrogenous bases complementary, what will be complementary nitrogenous bases? Thymine is always connected with adenine. So free nucleotides from cytoplasm, it will come. So here, what will come here? Adenine. As there is C, cytosine, so which nitrogenous base will come here? G. If there is G, so which nucleotide will come here? C. There is A, so T will come here. Like this way, you have to make sure that there are complementary nitrogenous bases written here. And obviously, there are bonds present in between adenine and thymine. There are two hydrogen bonds in between guanine and cytosine. There are three hydrogen bonds. Now, the thing is, this is the old strand. Also, this is the old strand. So, this in this old strand, if you write down T here, then obviously it will be A, because previously it was in twisted condition, it was in double strand condition. So A, there is C in the previous strand. So in this previous strand, there will be G. There is G in this previous strand, so there will be C. There is A in the old strand, so in this strand, there will be T. So what will be the new nitrogenous bases in this new daughter DNA strand? A, then it will be T. G, in case of G, it will be C. C, in case of C, it will be G. And T, in case of T, it will be A. So, like this way, you have to write down the complementary nitrogenous bases. And what will be the direction? Suppose this is 5 prime. So, how, where it ends? It ends up here. This is old 3 prime. If this is old 3 prime, so it will be new 5 prime, and it will be new 3 prime. So as this is 5 prime, it is old 3 prime. Old 3 prime, it is, so it will be old 5 prime. So this will be new 3 prime, and this is new 5 prime. So like this way you have to complete your diagram and you have to give description that DNA replication is done by semi-conservative method, and this method it was described by scientists Watson and Crick, and there are 3 steps in this DNA replication process. One is breaking down of hydrogen bond. Secondly, complementary nitrogenous bases come and start formation of new DNA strand, and thirdly, formation of new daughter DNA. So these are the steps of DNA replication. Another topics that we are going to know about, that is DNA test. All of we know that DNA technology, its use and application in different sectors, it has created one new type of new horizon in different sectors. So this one of this method is DNA fingerprint, and in case of medicine industry, in case of agricultural development, in case of development of fisheries and development of animal resources, this DNA technology now it is widely used, especially in case of criminal investigation process, which is traditionally mostly dependent on eyewitness or evidences. Nowadays, DNA test playing a very important role in case of clear identification of any person's identity, or for giving true justice. What is DNA test? What is DNA fingerprint? At first, organic samples are required. Organic samples are any kind of sample that may be blood, it may be tissue, it may be bones, it may be teeth. So any kind of samples are there. First, it should be collected. Secondly, this organic sample, it is matched with the suspected person's organic sample. So compare is done about DNA profile of suspected person or the person whose identity is not yet found in case of outside countries for biological parent identification. In our country, there are several types of tragedies are done, several tragedies like in Shahar Rana Plaza tragedy. So where we do not know about person's identification, so in that cases DNA fingerprinting, DNA test can be done, and matches are done with the relatives, DNA profiles are matched so that person's identity can be found. In case of criminal identification, if we suspect any person for that incident, his or her DNA is matched with that organic sample found from that place of incident, and then the person who is responsible for this incident or injury or any kind of occurrence, that is that can be found out. For this process, what is done? At first, I told you that organic sample is collected. From this organic sample, through chemical method, DNA is separated. This DNA, by the help of several types of restriction enzymes, it is cut into small pieces. I told you before what restriction enzyme is. Restriction enzyme is that type of enzyme which can identify small basic bases, 4 to 6 base pairs of nitrogenous base pair of DNA, and it can cut over here. So several restriction enzymes are used, and these samples, they are DNA, they are cut into several fragments. Then, by electrophoresis method, by the help of this electrophoresis method, these segments, they are made bands, visible bands. After that, one kind of nitrocellulose paper hybridization is done. Well, this fragments and radioactive isotope DNA probe, these are hybridized. Then in the X-ray film paper, these visible bands of probe, they are determined. And then matching, comparison of this DNA strand with the suspected person's organic sample's DNA. That is done, and then in case of any identification of any person or in case of criminal identification, this DNA matching, through this DNA matching process, these problems are solved. So, in from today's lecture, we have learned about Mendel's experiment. So, from this experiment, nowadays artificial hybridization process development in different sectors of agriculture, in fisheries, in case of different kinds of plants, animals, improvement that is done. We have learned about DNA replication process, how in the organism from one DNA two daughter DNAs are produced, what is the method, and lastly we have learned about DNA test, which has created a new horizon in different sectors in criminal identification, having proper justice and persons in case of persons identity. So in every processes, this has created a new horizon in research levels. So your homework will be, you have to draw DNA replication, diagram of DNA replication, semi-conservative method, and you have to describe it. So next class we're going to know about color blindness and human sex determination. So till then, I hope all of you will be fine, and I hope this lecture, it will help you a lot to understand about heredity of organisms. Allah Hafiz.